Commander Chambers joined DIA 2 years ago. Put on our Venezuela task force last August, tracking Antonio Medina, who's not only a rising star, he's also pro-American. That is a rarity in Venezuela.
Chambers turn up anything interesting?
Yeah, he covered his bases. Submitted multiple intelligence reports. Our job is to keep an eye on the local political terrain, particularly nations hostile to U.S. interests. See if anything big is coming down the pike. He was very meticulous.
Any chance Chambers is doing something illegal?
He's an absolute straight arrow. You know, if anything, the guy was too passionate about his work.
Medina is, quote, an opportunist. If he was elected to higher office, he would be worse than Hugo Chavez.
Worse than Chavez? A guy who called America a terrorist state? I thought Medina was a U.S. ally.
Hold on. Chambers' background is computer science.
And by that, you mean he was basing his assumptions on a souped-up HIPS analysis?
HIPS is experimental, not to mention classified.
Chambers was beta testing a version of HIPS, high-precision search. Basically, it analyzes everything a person says publicly over a lifetime to uncover extremist views otherwise missed.
In essence, yes.
Were any of these views missed?
By the intelligence community. CIA, DIA,
according to Chambers.
Hmm. Awkward.
Excuse me, who are you?
Intelligence analyst Nell Jones.
The algorithm, as used by Chambers, is unproven, and no replacement for human intel.
Yeah, I've played around with it a fair bit. I was able to spot General Manuel Noriega back when the U.S. supported him, Pol Pot in the early days, and Mikhail Gorbachev. When we still hated him, came out a moderate.
Chambers was in the early stages of intelligence gathering. Oh, it's interesting stuff, but ultimately a bit far-fetched.
Really? Because the stakes aren't? I mean, Venezuela has known ties to Iran, does it not? And we know that Iran has a clandestine nuclear program that could potentially spread to the southern hemisphere.
It's a remote risk.
And isn't it true that Venezuela's been trying to form a bloc with Bolivia, Nicaragua, and Cuba to counter U.S. dominance in the region?
There have been concerns.
Add into the mix a nuclear Venezuela, and now you have a nuke 90 miles off the coast of Florida, not to mention the more realistic possibility that these countries become a training and launching ground for Al-Qaeda.
Okay, now. Thank you.